Hey, Ken, it's Andrew here.
Hi. How are you, pal?
It's great. It's good to see you. I wanted to pivot the conversation to the other major issue that we've been talking about and grappling with as a country, which is the riots and arguably the seditious efforts that were took place last week. You've been outspoken on so many issues, including your support for President Trump. You've given lots of money over the years, including this past year to the National Republican.
I did not give him lots of money over the years. I did not give him lots of money over the years. I gave him money.
No, I said to the national. No, but also to the National Republican Congressional Committee, which of course has supported a number of a number of the congressional leaders who sought to overturn that vote or to have the electoral college vote reconsidered. My question to you is, what is your feeling about this today? And as I've asked others, including Mick Mulvaney, as somebody who supported this, do you feel like you enabled it to some degree?
I feel betrayed, okay? Going through the court system to try and get some results, he exhausted everything. It was over. Biden's the president. Biden should be in the White House. And I'll give you a very simple thing, Andrew. I think the biggest mistake anybody can make is to offer mitigating reasons why what happened last Wednesday was a disgrace and should never have happened in this country. And if it doesn't break every American's heart, something's wrong. It breaks my heart, for sure. I didn't sign up for that. And more importantly, I think right now all of us have one, to me, I'm speaking for myself. I'm going to do everything I can from day one to make sure I do my part to make Joe Biden the most successful president in the history of the country. And there's a selfish reason for that. We've got very serious, major issues in America to deal with. We've got the pandemic. We've got the debt. We've got infrastructure. We have a horrendous condition of public schools in America. We have generational theft. What the hell is a guy like me doing getting money from the government every month? I listened to Joe Manchin the other night. He was beautiful. He said, look, let's make sure we give people what money they need, but let's make sure they need it. To cavalierly give money, give $2,000 to every American is nuts. And don't depend on people to say, I don't need it, I'll send it back. What I'm saying, Andrew, is how do I feel? I feel those people who sought to stop the process were ill-advised. I think we have a strong responsibility as citizens of this great country to do everything we can to the government that's in power at the time to help them be the most successful. We need it. We need it bad. I don't know if I've answered your question or not, but that's the best answer I can give you.
Do you think the president should be impeached?
I don't care. I don't care. All I care about is one thing. January 20th, Joe Biden's going to be sworn in as president. And I'm going to work my ass off any way I can, because I win. If he's a great, successful president, we all win. Should he be impeached? Should he resign? I don't. I'll tell you something else. There's a lot of people right now in his administration that have worked like hell and are working like hell right now to do what they can to keep things going until January 20th when the new team takes over. Those people don't deserve to be ridiculed or besmirched or anything else, Andrew, okay? I think they're patriots. They're doing what they can. Notwithstanding, I'm sure many of them feel the same way. Those people that left the administration, they spoke their mind. I respect them for that. But there's a lot of people in there right now that are trying to keep things going until January 20th. And no glory for them at all. How do I feel? I don't care what you do. I was betrayed. And I feel I have a strong obligation to use whatever energy and whatever talent, whatever ability I have, to help Joe Biden be the best president we ever had, whatever that takes.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.